they would take the stairs in the back, not the same stairs of the boxers, different stairs. And they would run upstairs like crazy so they can be in front at least to see something, because they didn't have any chairs, any benches, so they had to stand for the whole time. We had a lot of people up there. And in the gallery, in the Pitronaria, in the back, they had a place to cook, like kitchen, like a trattoria, basically. We call it trattoria, so it was a real trattoria, but people would cook there for the food theater. So during the opera, you would smell all this, you know, tortelli and stuff while you would eat. And from up there, people would eat also on the different levels of boxes. So you would eat, I don't know if you already tasted the tortelli d'Erbetta, the classical super Parmesan food. And so eating, drinking, commenting all the time, spending time in the theater. So everybody was here, and it was a very important place, a very important gathering social place for everybody. So it was very important to have the right position though, because if you were in the boxes, this was the first step in society to have a box. It meant you were an important person. The position you had in the auditorium was also important, because the central boxes were for very important families. The second level was the most important of all the others, because you are at the same level of the royal box. So it meant a lot to be at the same level of the duchess. Then you have the third level that was still quite prestigious. The fourth level was for the artists, including the decorator of the theater, architect of the theater. They had a box on the fourth level, a side box. So not very prestigious, but still, they were assigned a box for themselves and for the duration of their life and all the heirs they would have forever. So it was okay. So Maria Luisa dies in 1847. We have a big change, a political change, because the Bourbon-Parma family returns to Parma. Until the unification of Italy, we will have the Bourbon-Parma family. And the new Duke, Charles III of the Bourbon-Parma family, he decides that it was time to change, because the classical style here inside the auditorium was obsolete. So it was time to change to something more popular. Different colors, different style, different decorations. So he asks a decorator, said designer / decorator, Girolamo Magnani, a very successful and famous one then, that was a local artist from Pudenza, so about 20 minutes from Parma. Magnani, back then, used to work a lot with Giuseppe Verdi. So Magnani had a trip paid throughout Europe and throughout Italy, like Maria Luisa at the beginning, to find the right style for the whole theater. And so he actually got inspired by the style of Milan. He didn't have to do all the strict detail, but the style of Milan was something that would inspire him a lot for the decoration. So he decided to really like that. So if you see some similarities, it's not just an impression, it is like several decorations are quite similar. But what Magnani decides is to keep the painting on the ceiling. So this stairs by with the fathers of tragedy and comedy is from 1829. So the last 1829 decoration in this auditorium. In the middle you see the sun. In Italian, we call the chandelier astrolabe. Astro means star, want more than he wants. And so this dispute is getting gas. And it was made in Paris, it was made in crystals, in bronze, and it is 3.5 meters large, 2.5 meters long, and it weighs 1 ton and 100 kilos. So today we have an engine that allows us to move the chandelier down without any problems. In the past, they had to do the movement by hand, so they did it manually. It would allow them to move it, but it required to have at least 4 or 5 people to do that movement. So, 1853, the whole structure changes. Well, not actually the structure, but the style, the decorations. So you have the real box up there. The real box was the box of Modernism of the Duke later on. Today, this is the box of the Ring. And inside, we have different changes as well. Apart from some decorations, the inside of the real box changes a lot too. But the crown remains the same. And so, in the crown of the real box, you have this small flower, and these are the violets. The flowers that were the most beautiful flowers for Maria Luisa because of the smell, the perfume, and also of the form of the color. So we have today Parma Violetta di Parma. It became one of the most famous perfumes, I think, in the world, because every time I talk about it, people recognize the smell, at least in Italy, or not exaggerating the world, but in Italy for sure. And so she found a way to extract the essence of the perfume she would use in the perfume. And in 1870s, it became a perfume for everybody. But before that, only Maria Luisa could use it. Another detail from 1829 is a clock. So in the middle of the Cassinian arch, all this beautiful arch, beautiful decorated, you have the number 2 in Roman numbers and 40 in regular numbers. So this is the clock that is 1 before the performance, usually opera performance or classical music. So we have a technician that usually works on the upper part of the singing tower, and he has to go inside this room with the clock. So you have the clock is composed by 2 rings. One of the hours, above you have the minutes, and they move horizontally. So the minutes move from 5 to 5, so you will have 40, 45, 40, 50, etc. And the hours from 1 to 12. Once it is working, it goes on for 7 hours and a half, and then it stops. So in the past, we had a person that would wind the clock all the time. Today, it's not possible to have a person there to keep the clock working. We don't spend so many hours in the open house today. In the past, they would spend the whole day and night until 2 a.m. So it was normal to have a person that would keep the clock going. So